Welcome, guys. Today I wanted to talk about why transforming villages is so much fun in Minecraft, why you should do that, and what's so useful about transforming villages. We are right now in the Snowy Kingdom, a village transformation project that I did in the past where I transformed a whole snowy village into a freaking kingdom with a freaking huge wall that goes all the way around there. We even got some really interesting cartography tower here, and there's just so much that I added to this village. I think those were just like 5 or 6 buildings when I arrived here, but we have extended it. We built some buildings that look like similar to the already standing buildings. We have this crazy huge bee farm that we all love, right? It's just so lovely having those huge buzzy bees fly around, right? There's just something so nostalgic and cool about this, right? Like, look at them. So nice. But yeah, talking about villagers and how useful they are. Like, in my opinion, it's really great to have villagers in either your base or if you're like transforming a village and turning it into a base like I did. To have all sorts of traits available, especially those from the blacksmiths. Like this one right there, I leveled him up and he offers me some really cool stuff. Like I can get, for example, some diamond boots with like projectile protection 4, what is really nice. Some feather falling, I guess it helps me when I mess up and end up falling from somewhere. But no, it's like really cool if you have villagers, because if you level them up, they're gonna offer you some cool stuff. Like, sometimes you get, like, really good enchantments, sometimes you get bad ones, but, like, keep in mind, you can have, like, multiple ones like that on Master, right? So, one will have the boots you need, one will have the helmet. And if you have, like, a lot of those, you have an infinite supply of diamond gear. So, you no longer need to worry about your shit breaking. Like, if my boots break, I just buy new ones. I don't fucking care, because I have so much, like, there are just 8 emeralds, but I have, like, a chest full of stacks of emeralds, so... It's really good to have villagers for trading. And if you're building a base, and that's what, like, I had like a big base, I had like a freaking castle, but the issue was when I built like a big castle, I was all by myself, and after building it and completing it, I got bored so easily because it was just me, many rooms, many floors, and I was nothing. I was so alone. So I ended up like getting all sorts of pets, like taming freaking cats, bringing them in. I even ended up dragging freaking sheep and cows into my base because I felt so lonely. And the thing about Minecraft is, especially if you start like a new seed, you spawn somewhere randomly. Like, you can be anywhere. You can be in a freaking desert in the middle of nowhere. You can be in a forest and there are maybe like no villages or nothing nearby. So if you ever discover a village, you suddenly realize, oh, I'm no more lonely. There are actually freaking NPCs. Even though they are a bit stupid and stuff, but there are freaking NPCs that... Why are there so many freaking iron golems in the water? Are you dudes going for a swim? Like, what the heck is happening here? I need to get them out somehow. I don't know how they got stuck in there. But yeah, if you notice, then you suddenly have like those freaking villagers you can talk with and you can even trade with them. That's a bad trade, by the way. Don't ever go for the 10 coal for emerald. You need this shit for like torches and lanterns, but that's fine if you're fishing a lot. Like, I don't know, you don't need to cook it anymore. It's a waste of emerald though. But yeah, I think it's like really cool, because also if you do transform a village and you have like a base, for example, in a village, like you make yourself like maybe like some freaking huge castle and it's like so freaking big, like your main base, for example, you also end up with some really cool ideas, like in your base, for example. Like here, I made a freaking shooting stand. You guys see that? And I was like, hey, you know what? Let's add some Fletchers here. By the way, they have great things also. Like here, bow punch 1, power 2. I no longer need an enchanting table. I no longer need to farm anything. I just trade. And you get like crazy ideas for your base, like making a freaking shooting stand. You come up with a freaking laboratory idea. Let's go to the laboratory. I think it's here. Yeah, you come up with like a freaking laboratory idea with like freaking crazy mad scientists doing some research here. Yeah, I still need to level this dude. You end up growing all sorts of plants, not in a farm outdoors, but inside your base, because you feel like, oh, that would really match. You end up coming up with those really long seeds and flowers and shit. So it's definitely worth it. transforming a village when it comes to creativity, because villagers, they give you great build ideas that you would not come up with yourself. I mean, you place down a block that is a working station, they get a profession, and then you think about it, like a cleric. What fits a cleric? He can be either a mad scientist, or he can have like a freaking church. So you end up building a freaking church in your village. And you would have never come up with this idea if it was just yourself. Because who wants to build an empty church with nobody in, right? For example. No, but seriously, guys, it's really, really good to transform villages because you bring life to your world. You're no longer lonely. You have all those villagers that constantly keep saying ha 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 ha. It's almost like they're laughing at you. Like they think you're a freaking walking joke or something, and you just sometimes want to punch them because they just ha 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 at you, right? Oh yeah, this is a lovely tower that I built. It's the freaking cartography tower, but I decided to also add a librarian, and he's offering me just a bookshelf. Dude, get a better offer, please. Oh, this tower is so comfortable. I love spending time here as well. And for starters, it's actually nice if you do locate when you start your village, because you can just use their beds as a freaking not only spawning point, but also to spend the night. Like, I'm always happy when I start like a world and have a village nearby. It doesn't even matter which biome, because I will upgrade it anyway, like here. Like, we even made a portcullis gate here. Like, that's something we built over multiple weeks, actually. This took eternity to build. Even as like a redstone function here. But yeah, let's head now to my most favorite village transformation project. But before we get there, let's do a quick comparison. So that's my transformed village right there. And you guys already saw like most of it. I do have some other buildings that are like a bit hidden there. But if you look at like a regular village like that, it's quite simple, right? And for some reason, all villagers died here. I guess too many spawns happened or something. Not even sure if one villager even lives. But yeah, if you look at it, it looks a bit boring, right? Like, you have like a few buildings, you have those like lantern holders here. But not much going on. But if you transform a freaking village, you add like multiple new structures, it just looks so much more interesting. And you can be proud of your work. Like, building a nice base and big house does feel great when you look at it at the end. But like, turning a small village into like a freaking city is even better. Like, it feels so rewarding to me. Anyway, let's head now to my most favorite project and my main transformed village. So now, guys, we are in the middle of the desert. We see nothing interesting behind me except for some sand hills, some cactuses, some dried bushes, and a very, very strange rabbit that's just like jumping around. Okay. I think that one is a bit weird, right? But anyway, so if you, for example, are lucky and you end up finding a desert village like I did here, like look at this. I have like a huge wall there with also a redstone gate over there, and this is by far one of my most favorite projects. And in a moment I will show you and tell you why this is my most favorite village transformation and in general transformation project in Minecraft on this world. And yeah, it's just so cool. I should actually get used to closing this. I always keep this opened. So now let's close this. So yeah, this here was a tiny, tiny desert village. There were just like, I think about like six structures or so here. And the gathering point, the old one here where the glazed terracotta blocks are. And I ended up adding more and more houses to there. We even built somewhere over there, a library. We have a freaking palace over there. We ended up creating this even bigger bee farm than in the snowy village. Like, look at this, that's even bigger. There are way more crops and it just looks nice. I decided to actually add like a tree to the middle. It looks nice. And what I really love so much about this one here is how we started from almost nothing and brought in so much. We even brought in here a freaking turtle that's for some reason stuck in a boat. Why is this one stuck in a boat? I'm confused. How did this one get in here? Anyway. So there was a bit of water. We were really lucky. So I found this village. I had like a few grass blocks over here. Let me show you that. So those, they were already here. I didn't place them. I was just lucky that there was like a small river biome nearby. So I had some grass blocks to work with. I could just bring them over there as well to create like a nice garden. Same with here. But if you have silk touch, or you end up fighting a enderman, for example, that just picked up a grass block, like, you have also ways to get a single grass block. It's no problem. And you can just spread the grass like I did over there as well. But yeah, what I love here is, in the desert biome, you don't have much, just mostly sand blocks, dried bush, and what we saw in the background before I entered this. But now that I brought in here so much, it feels like a whole different village. Like, everything just changed so much. Like, it's flourishing here. Like, life is happening here. I created a freaking oasis in the desert. And let me show you, like, my main base. I have, like, a main base in this world, and that's the desert palace. And we're gonna head there, and this one's stuck. And yeah, like, adding new structures, like, this is also a new building that I added with, like, some freaking stairs and stuff. Like, it just feels fun doing, like, smaller projects, even. Like, making a nice big base is nice, but make, like, smaller houses extra, or, like, small fisherman houses like I did over there. It also feels so great, because you not only see your accomplishment in, like, one thing, but you see it in, like, many things, in, like, huger projects. Like, here, for example, I created a desert market, and if you wanted to, we can do some nice trading here. You can get some new shears once they break. We can buy some carpet, bed, wood, whatever. There's also an armorer. I'm not sure what he's offering. Let's check. Yeah, some basic gear, but it's nice if it breaks and you don't need to bother farming so much iron. And yeah, let's head to my main base and let me show you how beautiful this is. Because I felt so comfortable being here, and it felt so good adding, like, new structures like this little farmhouse here, I ended up spending a lot of time here that I ended up building such a huge base. And if you look at this, like, this is absolutely nuts, guys. Like, this is probably the biggest building I ever created that I lived in. This one has, like, multiple floors as well. It has, like, those wings that also have, like, different professions and stuff in them. Like, here, for example, we have a Fletcher. I need to level this one. And we have, like, this simple fountain here. And you come up way easier with those builds and with, like, patience if you're working on many smaller projects nearby. Like, hey, let's build a small farmer house. Let's do this. Hey, I just this crazy idea. How about I build, like, a base that has, like, a small wall, like a garden, and then it starts just like here, right? And if you look in here, especially, like, the second floor. Hey, what's happening? I hear someone, but I don't see someone. How did this iron golem get in here? That's weird. Yeah, I love this library. What is this? Fortune 2. Okay, I don't need to lock this one. There's my beloved cat. Hi there. I still need to find a name for you. Okay, go back to your corner, please. Here's your place. A bit more. Because the villagers, they will just push you. Okay, you stay here. Be a good cat. Love you. What do you have? Flame. Oh, I have another cat here. I was like, what's happening? So many meows. And here's our tiny aquarium. Here we can cook something. Do we have some beef right now? Yeah, we already have it cooked. No problem. Let's get to the top and enjoy the view. We have, like, a freaking roof that we can stand on and just stare at this lovely chicken here, the flower garden that I created, those lovely trees that are blowing with the wind. And from here we can see, like, the whole desert kingdom. And there's a reason why I left some parts empty like that. Like, when I worked on this village transformation project, like, I was a big noob. This actually was at the beginning of my world career, you could say, like, with all those accomplishments I've done here. So I just added up, like, a few more simple buildings, or, like, this library. It doesn't look that spectacular, right? But if you look at, like, this building that I worked on, or the market, you can see here the progress with my building skills, how the market, how this and that looks, like, way better than this small corner over there, right? And same with, like, the big garden. This is also much newer, and this is also a bit newer, this house. So yes, kind of like also a reflection of yourself. If you're transforming a village in your world, you're also reflecting on yourself and your game experience, because a village transformation isn't something that happens just immediately. It's something that you do step by step. And sometimes, like me, for example, you will keep like a portion empty because you have some ideas for the future, but they are quite difficult to do, and you want to gain the experience first of all. So yeah, just building a base is nice, like this one, but it will be lonely. And if you look at like so many adventure games or RPG games, you have somewhere on the map always certain cities or villages that you can go to for either questing, for trading, maybe to sell some junk that you looted from like killing many monsters and stuff. And that's the same when you do village transformations. You end up on your map in your world creating interesting spots with some population, with some stuff going on, and just so much build freedom and creativity that you can just run wild. Like, seriously, I think it's so lovely, so great, and so fun to transform villages. And you don't get tired of your world so fast, because you end up staying in your world. You don't always just reset your world, because you know how much time and effort you invested in, and you always come up with like cool ideas. For example, now let's say you did a village transformation, a desert village like I did, and then you decide, hey, now there's the caves update, now we have those huge caves, how about I build an underground subway, like a freaking train station at the bottom of my base or something, right, like in the basement. And this one will lead to like another village, or maybe some outpost or something that you created. And just look at that, there's so much population. You're no longer as lonely as when you started your world. The only thing you need to get used to is this ha 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 all times. But apart from that, it's crazy fun, it's crazy cool. Like, I freaking love villages. I think villages are great. I think it's definitely worth transforming villages. And yeah, your world becomes less lonely. And you have many small projects, and you don't run out of ideas so quick. But anyway, guys, that's it for today's video. I hope this was helpful for you guys, and I managed to inspire you guys so you can also transform some villages and create freaking kingdoms and make your world just so amazing and so huge with many different interesting locations. I wish everyone a wonderful day, and please don't forget to like and subscribe. I'll see you guys next time.